Another day, another tier list video. Last time, we went over the low tiers, and now we're gonna go over the low mid tiers. If the terminology feels a bit confusing, it's because there are a lot of mid tiers in Ultimate, and you have to distinguish between them. So we have the high mid tiers and the low mid tiers. By the way, if you want to distinguish yourself from the rest of the competition, be sure to check out ProGuides.com. We've got lots of instructional content over there to help you improve, like live coaching, character guides, and courses from the pros. Mid-tiers in general tend to do better and have bigger player bases pushing their optimization than the low tiers. However, we aren't analyzing purely by results. Mid-tiers also tend to have mechanical advantages that keep them from being low tiers. They usually have better recoveries, better tools for advantage or disadvantage, better hitboxes, better damage output, better kill confirms, or a mix of all of that. Mid-tiers still do have some clearly defined flaws that often hold them back from high tier, though. The low mid-tiers in particular tend to have stronger strengths than the low tiers while having worse weaknesses than the higher tiers. The characters in this tier can and have done well in tournaments, but they'll struggle to win big ones. So we consider them not quite solo main viable, and we recommend picking up a secondary or co-main to cover their weaknesses. Let's start off the low mid-tiers by talking about some of the new entrants. The biggest, but maybe least controversial new member of C-tier is Ike. Ike had a very hot start in Ultimate, with MKLeo using the character to win S-tier tournaments. However, even when Ike was at his peak and ranked A-tier in our list and many others, there was still a lot of talk about how he'd fall later. Now it's happened. MKLeo and Mars have all but stopped using the character, and in turn, he hasn't had the best results. Ryuga and Raven King have put in work with the character and gotten some good results and upsets, but now Ryuga may be dropping the character. Ike is just a bit too one-dimensional. Ike has a neutral air that can do just about everything short of creating world peace. He has great combos, great kill power, great damage, great disjoints, and a pretty strong recovery. The problem is, he's slow, heavy, and gets outpaced in neutral by the many fast and agile characters in high tier. While his aerials are pretty good at walling out, once you break down that wall, Ike loses a lot more interactions. Ike is by no means a bad character now, he's just not gotten better while much of the rest of the cast has. Every Smash fan gets disappointed when they see the captain anywhere under high tier. It's hard to blame him. Falcon's a super fun character to watch and play. Unfortunately, Captain Falcon's ultimate form isn't his peak form. First, let's talk about what he does well. Captain Falcon still has great speed and damage output. He's also still got some nice and flashy kill confirms like down air into knee. He's also pretty durable and can juggle characters with his up airs pretty well. The buffs he got in 3.1 were also pretty meaningful, opening up new combo trees and helping out his neutral. That was why we had him in B tier in our last list. Now that the meta's progressed a bit more, his weaknesses feel more acute. Just like in past games, Captain Falcon's recovery is pretty mediocre, and he's vulnerable to rock-crocking. He's also a heavyweight with one of the fastest fall speeds in the game, so he's combo food. His speed is nice, but his turnaround animation is one of the worst in the game, which is a surprisingly large hindrance to his mobility as a whole. While he does have some solid kill confirms, they're also off of kind of obvious aerials, so they're not that hard to play around. Captain Falcon does have the benefit of a really strong and dedicated player base. However, even Fatality and Nixie haven't been able to consistently get past the finish line with this racer. So we've dropped Captain Falcon to C tier for now. He might rise up as players get better at canceling the turnaround animation and putting together combos though. Lucario is another character we moved down from B tier. We've dropped 5 total characters from B to C tier as the meta adjusted, which is one of the bigger changes to our tier list. As the meta has drawn on, it's a bit easier to separate player skill and character ability. That's the case with Lucario and Sue. Sue has long been one of, if not the best, Lucario main, and he's been trying out a lot of other characters because Lucario just feels lackluster. Lucario took a big nerf in Ultimate. It wasn't in the patch notes, and it wasn't a direct nerf like the former Smash 4 top tiers got. Ultimate's whole game state nerfed Lucario. Ultimate nerfed Rage and increased the amount of solid, stable kill confirms available to the cast. A lot of Lucario's strength came from being able to survive at high percents, build aura and rage, and straight up rob people, just steal wins right out from under their noses. And now the blue energy raccoon dog doesn't get the same value from Rage and dies earlier from all the good kill confirms. Since Nintendo didn't really give Lucario great base stats or combos to counteract this, he's been on the gradual decline down to C tier. However, he still does have some strong movement and combo options with his Aura Sphere. That, plus nice quality of life buffs and some solid moves, will keep him out of low tier. Speaking of former Smash 4 top tiers that don't fit the ultimate meta that well, here's Diddy Kong. We initially brought Diddy Kong out of C tier due to a number of really nice buffs Papa Nintendo gave him. After the buffs, Diddy Kong really did get needed improvements to damage, kill power, and recovery. However, we're bringing him back down for now as we haven't seen too many results with him just yet. Diddy Kong mains have scored some serious upsets, like Dakpo over Gluttony, but the consistent results aren't there quite yet. Plus, some of the upsets may have come from the surprise factor of Diddy Kong's very dumb new Infinite, the Pyramid Scheme. And Nintendo's gotta be trying to patch this out, right? Right, Nintendo? You're not just gonna leave this in here? Oh. Anyways, in Smash 4, Diddy Kong's banana was downright oppressive and one of the most reliable kill options and neutral tools. It's still pretty good, but it's a lot less strong now that most characters have similarly good kill confirms. In a meta full of disjoints and projectiles, it's also harder for Diddy Kong to get in and easier to get comboed and edgeguarded. All that said, we're gonna keep an eye on Diddy Kong, and you should too. Diddy's getting a lot of attention from players like Rivers, and we know those upsets weren't all because of the Pyramid Scheme. He's got some great strengths like speed, damage, and movement that could bring him back to B tier. Nintendo's trademark soulless fitness mannequins have also suffered from Ultimate's meta. Wii Fit Trainer was destined to be a weird character from the get-go. In Ultimate, Wii Fit's weirdness comes from their matchups. Wii Fit Trainer can have very polarizing matchups due to the volleyball and the character's odd hitboxes. Against some characters, Wii Fit can basically set up a volleyball game on the ledge. They pop up, chuck a volleyball, and pop back down until the other character gives them stage positioning. Against short characters, Wii Fit has trouble landing any hits. And that's a problem, because Ultimate's not just full of short characters, it's also full of characters that can easily low profile under attacks. Think Inkling and Greninja's dashes. We initially put Wii Fit Trainer up in B tier because deep breathing is just so good. Wii Fit has a lot of opportunities to deep breath, and deep breathing makes Wii Fit faster, stronger, and all around better. It's kinda like if Cloud picked up a gym membership. Unfortunately, being bad against short characters really hurts in Ultimate, so Wii Fit and their wonky hitboxes drop from high mid to low mid. This character can still be great for counterpicking, and can be good if you can find a secondary to cover bad matchups. Our last character to fall to C tier is Meta Knight. Meta Knight has been judged for his transgressions in Brawl, and like Kirby before him, he will pay for many games to come. But even though he's fallen from grace, there's a lot of good things about Meta Knight, like his combos, his edgeguarding, and his kill confirms. The tiny Dark Knight just gets outshined by other characters that can also combo, edgeguard, and kill better than him because their moves connect more reliably. Yep, they sure do. Anyway, Meta Knight also has that problem lots of multi-jump characters have where they just aren't that fast in the air, hurting what should be a super strong aerial game. Meta Knight also lost a prominent main in the form of Abadongo and hasn't had super strong results in Ultimate. That said, the character could come up the tier list with further optimization. Costa Rica's top player Ye, pronounced Jay, but not to be confused with Jay, who is also a very good Meta Knight player from Montreal, has used the Little Round Swordsman to take wins off of Meister. Still, we don't recommend solo maining the character, unless your tag is bought. And you do voiceovers for this channel. Then, you're good to go. It's time to be a bit more positive and talk about the characters who came up from the low tier and into low mid tier. Jigglypuff recently got a lot of buffs that made the character work much better. Puff now has more reliable rest confirms, better edgeguarding, and more ways to set up into strong edgeguards. Puff still struggles from the fact that Rest went from the best kill move in Melee to a mediocre one in Ultimate. The dreaded Drill into Rest combo is still finicky, as is Pound into Rest, and both options are kinda telegraphed in the first place. She also struggles from a game full of disjoints, good aerials, and great recoveries that can completely throw off her Gimp-based game plan. Don't expect Puff to float to the top of Ultimate's tier list without more buffs, but expect Puff mains to start showing up more now that the character functions a lot better. Robin also got a lot of nice buffs that put them up a notch in our tier list. Because Robin isn't played a ton, it's easy to miss them, but the buffs basically improved Robin's out-of-shield options, disadvantage, advantage, kill power, and pretty much everything. These weren't Ken and Ryu level buffs that will rocket the character up, but they're a lot better now. In general, Robin has great projectiles and setups that make the character strong in advantage. However, Robin is the second slowest character on the ground in the game for some reason and doesn't have super great defensive options even after a neutral air buff. So Robin's disadvantage can be pretty rough. Good Robin players like Jewel and Kia do improve their movement using wave bounces and B reverses, but other characters with good base stats can do that as well. Other projectile characters like Samus and Snake also have more oppressive advantage states along with less punishable disadvantage states. Robin's buffs do go a long way, but in a game with this many characters, the climb up the tier list is even longer. Speaking of zoners on the come up, Mi Gunner also rose from low to mid tier. Mi Gunner has similar problems to Robin, being too slow for the higher tiers. However, Mi Gunners do have the projectiles to be oppressive at the ledge and an advantage. Unlike the other two Mis, they fit their zoner archetype pretty well, even if there are better zoners in Ultimate. The Mis as a whole tend to lack representation because they kinda just look wonky. Admittedly, styling on someone with a bite-sized Samus is kinda hilarious, and styling on someone with Sans or Cuphead is a meme in and of itself. But a lot of people would rather play the franchise characters that had a whole team of concept designers working to make them cool. That lack of representation makes all Mi characters harder to judge because it means they lack results and optimization. From what we can tell, Mi Gunner has just that bit more raw potential than the other Mis. The character has nice large hitboxes, good drag downs, good projectiles, and enough to be in mid-tier. However, the character doesn't have the raw speed, defensive options, kill power, and results to be higher. If we really want to talk raw potential, then we gotta bring up the Ice Climbers. This dynamic duo's been using desyncs and grab loops to terrorize Smash for a while now. In Ultimate, Ice Climbers still have a lot of deadly options out of desyncs, even if they don't have nearly as workable and consistent zero to deaths. Ice Climbers are also starting to get results. Big D made it onto the PGR, PlayerUnknown just had a great showing at Frostbite, and Daiki in Japan is doing well too. These are nowhere close to the results most high tiers get, but they're pretty good and definitely an improvement from the early days. As Ice Climber mains hit the lab, they make the Ice Climber's neutral and punish games a lot better and even learn how to control the AI. So while the Ice Climbers are C tier right now, they could climb higher. However, they are held back by a lack of tools. A lot of other characters have better disjoints, better edgeguarding, better recovery, and even better ways to carry someone over to the ledge and dunk them. We're looking at you, Mario! Ice Climbers also rely a lot on grab to get their best punishes, which is rough because grab's not that good in this game. On top of all that, they struggle to get in on zoners, which is a big archetype in Ultimate. Ice Climbers don't fit that well into Ultimate's meta, and optimization can only do so much about that. This might seem weird to hear at first, but Rosalina and Luma have a lot in common with the Ice Climbers. Both benefit a lot from tight window, execution-heavy desyncs. Both have a lot of room for optimization and growth because of that. And for different reasons, both can struggle in Ultimate's meta. Where the Ice Climbers struggle against zoners, Rosa struggles against really strong rushdown characters. Rosalina is one of the tallest and lightest characters in the game, a terrible combo that makes her super easy to hit and kill. Her lack of hitbox on her recovery also makes it pretty exploitable, a lot more exploitable than DeBuzz makes it look. But this Galactic Princess does have great hitboxes, a great ability to control the stage with Luma, good ledge trapping and edgeguarding, and even some nice combos. With time, and with players like DeBuzz and Kirihara at the helm, Rosalina really could rise up a lot of tier lists. However, we want to see Rosalina stand up more as a solo main before we push her up the list. Right now, DeBuzz still covers several bad matchups with his trusty Olimar. Ganon also struggles to fit into Ultimate's meta. While Ganon has some really fast moves and a whole lot of kill power, he lacks speed, recovery, and ways to deal with zoners and camping. Lots of Ultimate's cast can choose to stay away from Ganon's big hitboxes and pummel the Warlock from afar. Ganon's raw kill power and surprisingly fast moves keep him in mid-tier, but even in terms of kill power, Ganon is outclassed. Characters like Terry have just as strong kill options and confirms that are flat out faster. Characters like Byleth have just as strong kill options with better range. Both have better recoveries, faster ground speed, and better neutral games than Ganon. Truthfully, as the meta advances, it may even leave Ganon behind. It's possible that his kill power and high reward moves will keep him in mid-tier, but as the faster characters get more optimized, as players learn how to camp at Edgeguard Ganon, and as players move to better high-risk, high-reward characters, Ganon could slide further down the list. Sheik has the exact opposite problem of Ganon. That's getting kills. Sheik's lack of kill moves has been a known problem for a while. Void has shown the character can still take a stock using a mix of drag downs, ledge trapping, needle kill confirms, and edge guarding. However, many characters live to high percents against Sheik. That's particularly bad, since Sheik has less weight than Olimar. All that rage means you even see Void win neutral twice as much as his opponent, only to lose the game off of a raged up kill move. Sheik does have a lot of good things in Ultimate. A strong recovery, great speed, great combos, and useful neutral tools. Her lack of damage and kill power still sets her back enough to keep her in low mid-tier. With optimization, Sheik could rise higher, but it doesn't look like anyone but Void wants to optimize her, and it's easy to see why. She's Peach levels of effort with much less reward. Okay, so imagine a character, even lighter than Sheik, that for some reason has a huge tail that counts as part of their hurtbox and makes them super easy to hit. You are currently imagining Mewtwo, another one of the characters punished for their Smash 4 strength. No longer can you jump around the stage neutral air dodging out of harm's way. God, remember when he could fare out of that? Anyway, despite the obvious weakness of being easy to hit and kill, Mewtwo has some crazy strengths. He's surprisingly fast, with the 8th best run speed in the game. He has great damage output and some pretty solid kill confirms. He has good ability to deal with zones and some solid hitboxes and aerials. And he's got some cool disable setups too. Unfortunately, the huge hurtbox combined really does make that big a difference. Mewtwo's disadvantage wasn't that great already, and with the added tail hurtbox, Mewtwo mains basically have to be careful of turning around, because the tail exposes itself. This is such a huge blow, because quick pivot grabs and attacks are crucial in Smash. This also makes Mewtwo's movement so much more awkward than it should be, making him less fun and less played than he should be. Please, Nintendo, just take the hurtbox off the tail. Mewtwo's tail makes him easy to hit, but he still may not be as easy to hit as King Dedede. Dreamland's own absolute unit has had one too many picnics with Kirby and entered Ultimate as one of the fattest and slowest characters. He has one of the slowest run speeds behind Ike and the Belmonts, and he has literally the slowest airspeed. His frame data isn't great either. The only thing he is fast at is falling, which means he's not combo food, he's an entire combo buffet. So why is King Dedede even low mid-tier? Well, King Dedede has surprisingly good hitboxes. Coupled with his jumps and his Gordo, that means his advantage state is pretty good. He can juggle well, he can ledge trap well, and he has some pretty pesky moves like neutral air. While every character can hit his Gordo back, it's not that easy to do, and turns into a useful execution test. He also lives very long and can be harder to kill than other heavies because he can mix up his landing more with his multiple jumps and crazy fast fall. And once he does get rage, a lot of his moves will steal stocks right out from under his opponents. While he's not doing crazy hot in terms of results, Zaki still performs well with him. He can be a pretty solid counterpick, secondary, or co-main character that can abuse certain matchups and matchup inexperience. Simon and Richter Belmont are the heavy zoners that you probably don't think of as heavy zoners. Normally, heavy zoners are just a little big-boned, like K-Rool or Dedede. These two vampire hunters are heavy too, though. It's just all muscle and, like, whips and vials and stuff. The Belmonts embody what it means to be a zoner. They are oppressive when they play at the distance they want to. If you don't understand how to play around their advantage state, you're probably gonna die very early to Holy Water into F Smash. They have a hitbox to cover pretty much most approach options so that they can play keep away pretty well too. The Belmonts can control the stage, ledge trap, get kills, and do a lot of damage, but they have their fair share of zoner problems that keep them low mid-tier. First, like many zoners, they have a poor disadvantage state and look a lot worse when you close the distance and start a combo. Second, they have a very poor vertical recovery, which makes them easier to edgeguard. And third, their range is great against brawlers, but other zoners often outrange and counter them. The Belmonts have such a mix of very heavy strengths and weaknesses that they become very polarizing. They can win some matchups hard, but then lose others just as hard. They can have all the control one moment and lose it in the next, so they're staying in our C tier. Now for a lightweight zoner, Duck Hunt. This bizarre character is where we argue against results. Duck Hunt has some surprisingly good showings in Ultimate, and not just from Raito, the 17th ranked player on the PGR. Duck Hunt has good results from Sekai Dago, Vintendo, and Wisdom too. However, Duck Hunt is almost a consensus mid-tier in Ultimate tier list despite the results. Duck Hunt does have great zoning tools, good damage options, good pokes, and so many weird setups. He can really push players to their limit by filling the screen with so much retro game nonsense that they get a migraine while waiting for the terrible laughing dog to finally end their misery. Duck Hunt's frame 1 can also makes his disadvantage more manageable. The issue is, Duck Hunt really struggles to kill and has a pretty bad recovery. Think Olimar's, but worse. This wouldn't be so bad, but Duck Hunt is also lightweight and really abuses matchup inexperience. At the top level of competition, top players will gradually learn Duck Hunt as they play him in bracket. Then they'll come back and beat the character. This has happened to Raito with Elegant and DaBuzz, who both lost to Raito in winners of a tournament, then beat him in losers. Raito's results also seem to be leveling out a little, and recently he hasn't made as many top 16s. So, we think Duck Hunt belongs in low mid-tier. He just has good mains who abuse matchup inexperience. Finally, there's Lucas, the screaming Earthbound child you and I both nearly forgot about. Lucas is pretty overshadowed by Ness, who just has more combos, damage, and general strength. However, Lucas has his own stuff that makes him more than an Echo, like his Zer, which can start combos, and his insanely powerful throws. Lucas's high damage, solid recovery, good projectiles, and good kill throws mean that he's a pretty good character all around. He just doesn't have any really great standout strengths, which makes him worse than a lot of high mid-tiers who often have at least one thing that they're great at. Lucas's kill power isn't actually that great despite 3 kill throws because his grab isn't that great and it's dangerous to overuse. His ledge trapping and edge guarding aren't super threatening either. Lucas has about the results you'd expect from a low mid-tier too. He has some notable mains like Mekos, but otherwise doesn't really shine at big events. He's got no huge flaws, but no huge strengths either, and rounds out our low mid-tier. Phew, that's a lot of C-tiers. Our B and C-tiers are our two largest ones. Ultimate just has so many good characters. Seriously, any of these characters have more strength in Ultimate's meta than much of the cast in Melee, Brawl, or Smash 4. Every character here could be a good one to main, especially if you enjoy them. Just know that down the line, these characters may be tough to advance with as you run into players that know the matchup or play your bad matchups. That may lead to you needing a main or at least a secondary down the road, but that's not the worst thing in the world, and it happens to various top and high tier mains too. A lot of these characters have potential too, and they're just waiting for the right player to show the world what they can do. So if you do end up loving one of the low mid tiers, chase your bliss, follow your heart. You get the idea. And if you want any help along the way, you can head over to ProGuides.com too and learn from the best low mid-tier main in the world, DaBuzz. Be sure to click that subscribe button and check in tomorrow because we're rolling out the high mid-tiers next.